The former congressional staffer who is accusing former Vice President Joe Biden of sexual assault is speaking out in a new interview. Tara Reade opened up about her alleged experiences on Capitol Hill back when Biden was a senator and about who she told. CNN political correspondent MJ Lee has the breaking details. And MJ, what did she say?
Well, Brooke, for the most part, she reiterated what she has previously told CNN and other outlets. She described this alleged sexual assault by Joe Biden in 1993 when she was working as a Senate aide on Capitol Hill back when Joe Biden was a senator. Now, Biden, as you'll recall, he personally denied this sexual assault allegation last week. And so this was the first time that we heard Tara Reade respond to what Joe Biden himself said. So here's a little bit of that interview.
If he's watching this, mm-hmm. what do you want to say to him?
I want to say, you and I were there, Joe Biden. Please step forward and be held accountable. You should not be running on character for the president of the United States.
Now, Reade also said that she is willing to go under oath and is willing to be cross-examined. But when she was asked whether she is willing to take a polygraph test, she said she would if Joe Biden were also willing to do so. And she also said in this interview, I am not a criminal. Brooke.
Now that we're understanding, you know, that there is new reporting related to Reade's old divorce records, right? Walk me through what we now know.
That's right. And just some important context first. Remember, last year, Tara Reade came out and said that she had had physical interactions with Joe Biden when she was an aide in the Senate that had made her feel uncomfortable. But at that time, she was only talking about sexual harassment. And it's only this year that she publicly came out for the first time and said that actually she was also sexually assaulted by Joe Biden. Now, a local California paper got a hold of 1996 divorce records between Tara Reade and her now ex-husband. CNN has since obtained those records as well. And in those records, her ex-husband says that he met Tara Reade in the spring of 1993 in Washington, D.C. And when they were dating on multiple occasions, he says that Reade said that there was a problem that she was having at work regarding sexual harassment in U.S. Senator Joe Biden's office. And he also said in this document that this event had a very traumatic effect on Reade and that she is still sensitive and affected by it today. Now, just to be very clear about these divorce records, it mentions sexual harassment. It does not mention sexual assault. And it also does not say who perpetrated this alleged sexual harassment. But it is significant, this document, because it does appear to be the first sort of written record that Reade did tell somebody that she was close to in the 1990s about some kind of issue that she was having while she was working at Joe Biden's Senate office. Now, I should also note, and this is important, Reade has also said that she verbally complained at the time to supervisors about sexual harassment, though not about sexual assault. CNN has spoken with all three of those former supervisors of Tara Reade's, and they all said unequivocally that this complaint was never brought to them and that they were never aware of any kind of sexual harassment allegation against Joe Biden in the many years that they all worked for him, Brooke.
What about Joe Biden and his campaign? Are they addressing this divorce document?
The campaign is not commenting on the divorce document, but Kate Bedingfield, the campaign's deputy campaign manager and spokesperson, she put out a new statement yesterday pointing to growing inconsistencies, she says, in Tara Reade's accounting of all of this. I just want to read a part of that lengthy statement. Bedingfield writes, "Women must receive benefit of the doubt. They must be able to come forward and share their stories without fear of retribution or harm. And we all have a responsibility to ensure that. At the same time, we can never sacrifice the truth. And the truth is that these allegations are false and that the material that has been presented to back them up under scrutiny keeps providing their falsity." Now, Bedingfield pointed to Reade telling the Associated Press last year, quote, "I wasn't scared of him, that he was going to take me in a room or anything. It wasn't that kind of vibe." Bedingfield also pointed to the fact that an anonymous friend of Reade's, this is a friend who says that Reade told her about this alleged sexual assault back in 1993. This friend told Vox last year, quote, Biden never tried to kiss her directly. He never went for one of those touches. Now, CNN got in touch with this friend earlier today, and she confirmed that she did say this to Vox last year, but that she stands by it, and that what she meant was that in the instances where Tara Reade experienced physical interactions with Joe Biden in front of other people that made her uncomfortable, in those instances, Joe Biden never tried to kiss Tara Reade. So that's the explanation that we are getting from this friend.
Brooke. Okay. MJ Lee, thank you for that.